Okay, here we go. So the interesting thing about these dungeons is that you only have one opportunity to go through them. You have a bunch of creatures. I can't remember if we went through this the last video or not, but we'll go through it anyway. So there's a bunch of creatures that you have to fight in order to get the treasures, and then there's these dice which give you a random bonus at the beginning of a match. There's these questions that are really easy questions about cards in the game, and then there will be treasure, and usually those treasures are guarded by a bunch of different creatures. So the lives will stack. They'll continue to give me extra bonuses, but the card bonuses you can only have one at a time. So usually I like to walk around and go everywhere that I can go that is not... See, that's a free treasure, but I would rather wait on this and use the primal clay that I have than to just go and grab the treasure at no cost. Like, you're going to blow some of the other stuff that you could otherwise have advantage-wise if you do it that way. So I'm going to try to go the deepest I can into the dungeon without attacking a creature, and I'm going to fight this crusader with a primal clay in play. I'm going to have it be a 2-2 flyer, I think. Yeah, we'll have it start as a 2-2 flyer. This is a really good start for us. We've got terror and swords in hand, and the mana to play it, plus the threat in play. So I think that this deck plays White Knight. Oh, Rainbow Knights, okay. So we can terror that Rainbow Knights, which is nice. Rainbow Knights is one of the special cards. It comes in with a random color of protection, and then you can pay two. It's like the Pump Knights from Fallen Empires, where you can pay two to give it a bonus, but it's at random what the bonus is. So sometimes it's zero, sometimes it's two. Yeah, so we're going to terror this guy after we've made him use all of his mana. This is looking pretty good. Northern Paladin, destroy target black permanent. That's pretty awesome for him. But we're going to have a huge wall, thanks to his crusade, so he can't actually attack. And we'll keep chip-shotting with the flyer. A second Northern Paladin is fine. Flying is so awesome this game. And Crusade is really awesome for us right now. Sleight of Mind is turning that to white. This costs how much to activate? Two? Well, I kind of felt like that was going to happen, but there was... So sometimes the artwork on this is really... it throws you off, because even though these have different pictures, it doesn't necessarily coincide to, like, what the effects will show. Like, he could target this one, and it could show the artwork for this one, so I wasn't 100% sure which one of the ones he was targeting, and it's really difficult. Like, there's no arrows or anything to show you which one it is, so I didn't want to just swords the wrong one accidentally and then lose to it. So I kind of had to wait for him to sleight of mind. That's unfortunate, but At least he didn't blow up our wall of swords. So we're still not in terrible shape. So he's got a 5-2 first striker that he can't attack with because wall swords will still block it. And we've got approximately 1,000 lands and nothing to do with them. Same situation. I'm really impressed with how many lands this deck has managed to draw over the course of the last, like, 3 games. I don't know that that's standard, but it's kind of frustrating. He must have drawn something good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, yeah, Righteous Avengers it is. Good timing. Said Planeswalk, but it's showing Forestwalk. That's odd. And once again, Moat plus a flyer is better than this whole game. So I might not draw many spells, but when all of your spells are Moat and flyers, it doesn't really matter how many you draw, it seems like. Although this Northern Paladin Sleight of Mind thing is kind of sweet. Did I get there? We got there! Alright. Good job, us. We get a Mana Vault in the next duel. That's a pretty good bonus, but I think we can do better.